Hi, how's it going? Today I'm gonna talk a little bit about the use of the pedal, the sustain pedal in Brazilian music. And I'm gonna talk about bossa nova, samba and other styles. Many people think it's just use the pedal, don't use the pedal. And I think the interesting thing is to create some concepts of using and don't using. Let's talk a little bit. The first thing I would like to talk to you and show you, it's the use of the pedal when I'm doing two function left hands that imitate the acoustic guitar, for example. I'm using the pedal, and you also can hear it, and I'm using no chords because I'm doing a more legato sound. I'm using a less percussive concept of the bossa nova when I want to sound more lyrical. So I use just in each beat. All right. So note. Let me show you. I press. When I play the lower note, I took off the pedal and play again. So, one pedal four, I take off and step again. It sounds all the time clear. You don't, for example, if I didn't take off the pedal, some messy sound. I always want to sound clear. All the notes are clear, right? The pedal is giving a little bit of more sound for they are a little bit longer, these notes, but I'm hearing everything. All right, so this is the basic use of the pedal. When I don't, I want to use some feels in the bossa nova groove. I took off the pedal. Let me show better. This give a little bit more of swing. When I'm playing the comping piano, I'm also changing the pedal in each beat of the song, alright? There is a concept that some person thinks that people say that you just change the pedal in when you change chords, but in Brazilian music it can, depending on the style, it could be a little bit different. Alright, in this case I'm trying to not to mixture this lower notes, so I'm sounding with pedal, but I'm press the pedal, take off when I play the new one. The pedal always enters after after you play the note. So I'm showing with my leg. It's delayed. And this is a very lyrical way to play bossa nova, alright? And sometimes you often gonna see when I'm playing, I like to give a little bit more of samba feel. And in this way I use less. Or I use samba in the second beat. So just paddle in the first I don't use or when I'm doing. Paddle is helping me to make the second beat longer. Okay, so to play samba, let's talk a little bit about samba, so I'm gonna return to the bossa nova. Interesting thing about this kind of groove, it's that some people use ba, bom, ba, bom, bom, ba, bom, ba, bom. I use this more, this eighth notes, as variation, alright? I don't use so much then. Right, so when you're playing a rhythmic piece, you have to use very careful. If not, if you don't use, you're gonna do some attacks that you want to sound. For example, when we are playing samba, we are imitating the tambourine. It's not the pandeiro, like we say, the tambourine, it's a drum, a small drum that we play with the stick. That sounds has a very dry sound. So be careful to not to transform this in a attack, a wetter attack. So you are losing the language, you are sounding out of the language, right? One interesting concept I think when I'm playing the piano and using the pedal, it's when the style wants to sound more lyrical, it's a romantic song or a sadder song, I prefer to use more pedal. So for example, and when I'm playing a more percussive way, a drier sound, but when I have to give a little bit of emphasis on the second beat, or when for example here I'm playing a lot of chords, if I play without pedal I can use a little bit in one of pedal in each chord. Starting delayed, alright? Press the chord, press the pedal. And when I play the next chord, my foot goes up and I play again. So I'm gonna play the next, my foot. It's like my foot that does the contrary motion of my hands. So my hand, my foot, I think this is my foot. Again, right? So or if the song is more lyrical, you can use more pedal to create an atmosphere of the sound. For example, let me play a little bit of a slow choro. Thank you. is a phrase on the lower part of the piano. If I play it with the pedal, it's gonna get dirty, the sound. It's gonna do very wet, and you're gonna think it's dirty. So when I have phrases on the bass, in each style you are playing, you have to clean the pedal. You don't have to play anything to make the sound clear. All right. So for example, again. Very well when we are doing some arpeggio of the chord, but when we are doing phrases, for example, I clean up the pedal. Phrases on the left hand, to take off the pedal, leave all clean till you hear the phrase. All right, I hear a lot of musicians playing phrases like that, and you can understand nothing. All right, what else we can talk about the pedal? Other way, for example, it's to give a little bit of accent. Let me show if I can use here. Well, I'm using all the pedal to emphasize the first 16th note of the fourth. So this is a very interesting resource you can use to do also to create the sensation of the percussion when you're playing the shuro, for example. Alright, the pedal can be used also to help when you have to change fast your hand from one point to another. Case, I'm gonna try to remember some example. But one idea, while I don't remember the example, one idea that I think it's very important to you have clear in your mind, it's the song that I'm playing, it's more percussive or more lyrical. And if it's more lyrical, you can use the pedal more to, and use thinking in the different chords, alright, to get the song longer. And if you are playing a more percussive way, you can use the pedal just to make a little bit of accent, to help sometimes to don't leave the sound so so dry when you are changing a lot of chords. And that is a very interesting question that people ask. If I can use the pedal when I was younger, I had some group practicing that the teacher said we couldn't use the pedal while playing in group, and it depends a lot. You have a lot of situations where you can use the pedal to, for example, I'm playing a bossa nova. The careful I take, it's just to not sound messy, alright? For example, if I don't change the pedal, I just change the pedal when the chord changes. And depending on the piano, it's gonna make it so third. One important thing about the pedal is that different pianos have different responses. In the pedal, so you have to adapt yourself to the situation. This is very important to say also. And when you can change the mood of the group, for example, I'm playing a very slow boss, for example, Corcovado. After that, for example, so I change the mood of the group when I do this, when I start there. Take off the pedal, the group is gonna change the way they are playing. All right, so this is a very interesting tip I can use when I'm playing in trio. So the pedal is allowed when you're playing in trio. Just the careful you have to take it, not to sound mixture and sound messy. All right, the conclusion, it's the important points in this live were you have to adapt yourself to the piano, to hear. Always you search for a clear sound, and when you are doing low phrases, don't use the pedal. In percussive rhythms, as samba, for example, you can use the pedal to mark the beat to give a little emphasis on the second beat. And in bossa nova, you can play if it's more lyrical, if you are searching for a lyrical comping. If you have a more percussive comping in bossa nova, avoid the pedal. Because in this groove, for example, you have some ghost notes, and the pedal is gonna give much more importance to these notes that they deserve. Alright, they are just to create swing, not to be heard. Alright, so that's it. If you wanna, I don't know if this subject is interesting for you. If it is, I'm gonna record another live showing in my acoustic piano. The power of the pedal and the use, the details, and all right. So tell me if you think it's interesting, this live for you. Then I'm gonna prepare some more specific and good material for you. Alright, so thanks for watching. I appreciate your audience and see you every day for quick tips and lives about the Brazilian accent, improvisation, and how to play the Brazilian piano in an authentic way. Bye bye, obrigado, thanks for watching.